Cleanup time!
When you hear that, it's time to follow the ceramics cleanup procedure. When it is time to put away your clay, don't pull a Kobe! That is just irresponsible and disrespectful. Walk it over and nicely place it in the bin. If you're working on a project, make sure to wrap it in wet paper towels and put it in a thick plastic bag so it won't dry out. And then you can go ahead and place it in your periods cabinet. Make sure you clean up your table by putting all the tools back in the jars, all the rulers back in the cabinets, and anything else back where it's supposed to be. Ah, darn. If your table has sink duty, make sure to wipe up the sink and the area around the sink. Also, if any glazing was done today, make sure to clean the glazed table.
I'm on.
That was a close one. So when your table has mopping duty, you need to make sure that you dunk your sponge in the water, squeeze it all out, and then when you mop the floor, you want to mop in circles like a racetrack. Alright, so now that I'm done on the wheel, it's time to clean up the wheel. First thing you're going to want to do is take your bat off and grab your bowl and walk it over to the sink. Chances are everything's covered in clay. So you want to take a sponge, get it nice and wet, and clean everything very thoroughly. This is all for the next person who's going to use the wheel. If you don't want to clean up someone else's mess, then you shouldn't leave them a mess either. Now it's time to clean the splash guards. So you get a thumb on each of these tabs and you push down and they click right off. After we clean the splash guards, we want to take our sponge and come clean the wheel itself. Make sure to wipe up every part of the wheel. And if you spilt, make sure to even mop underneath and around. Now it's time to put the wheel back together. So put your bat in the cabinet, grab your bowl and your splash guards. It's time to go strap it on. Put your bowl right there, and the splash guards go on just as easy as they came up. All you have to do is slide them together. And we're done. I'm bringing sexy back. When you start to wipe the table, make sure you get that sponge soaking wet. You want it to drip. Wipe the entire table nice and slow. Don't miss a single square inch. But really, make sure that your sponge is wet, because if it's dry, it can create dust, and that's a health hazard.